placate descendants of the enslaved workers.
Our Courtney Stewart sat down with one of those descendants to hear what the memorial means to her. Courtney.
Chris and Tara, while many of the enslaved laborers' names have been lost to history, Myra Anderson says knowing what role her ancestor played gives the memorial a personal meaning.
Thirmston was sold to the university proctor Arthur Brockenberg for $600.
Thirmston Hern is Myra Anderson's ancestor, and his role at UVA is documented in a book by Monticello historian Lucia Stanton.
After the death of Thomas Jefferson, he was sold to the University of Virginia. He was a stone cutter, and he actually laid the foundation outside of the rotunda.
Anderson knew she was descended from the enslaved laborers at Monticello, but this new information about Thirmston Hern had an immediate impact on her.
It actually gave me chills when I was reading it, because in reality, we all African Americans know that their ancestors were enslaved, but to know the names and to know what it was that they did and the contributions that they made, it makes it seem more real.
Anderson says the construction of the memorial at UVA has brought up mixed emotions.
It has been one of those things that feels like exciting, but at the same time feels very, very, very heavy.
She's thinking not only of her own ancestor, but of the thousands of others whose names may never be known.
And it's all of these years later, and we're just now starting to give them that acknowledgement, even though the university has flourished based on their labors.
She says the memorial to enslaved laborers will give dignity and respect to the people who toiled at the school under slavery.
Sometimes the first step in correcting something in history that wasn't morally right is to acknowledge that. And I think that is the essence of what this memorial is doing, is taking the time to acknowledge something that has always been there, but has never really been talked about.
Now, Courtney, has Myra had a chance to see the site yet?
She has not seen it yet, but she says that she and other descendants have been invited to a special event that will be held this fall. They'll get to see it complete and just really be given a private experience there. And you were able to go on a tour. I know a lot of people got excited about that. Are there more opportunities for that sort of educational tour happening this summer?
Yeah, so the one I went on a few weeks ago was sold out. I mean, it was just immense interest, and so they have said they're going to be scheduling more events through the summer and into the fall, and so I guess they'll be announcing those dates.
And we'll keep you guys posted on CBS19news.com. Courtney, thank you. Jack?